Okay, we got a box that's hanging here. It's not grounded, as you can see. We're going to screw it into the wall here.
Well, investigators are executing a search. Ray Moody confesses to killing Brittany Drexler.
Mom's going down to Ocean Boulevard to drink my mom with fresh soil dried up, and I saw the Drexler worker walking on the sidewalk. Did she ask for a ride, or did you ask her for a ride? Did you ask her if you wanted a ride?
You remember? I asked her if she might have brought her with us.
Okay.
Did she share it?
Right. Angel was with you when you picked up Brittany. Is that correct? She rushed to get in the car.
She was sitting in the passenger seat, so we started driving, just trapping her, walking. To the spot where we used to camp out down by the river. And I was by myself with her. Because Angela left a while, Jesse or something. Just didn't get out of hand. She panicked and strangled.
Moody's statements are that the murder and the strangulation and the rape all occurred at the landing. But at that point, it's just a confession. And it doesn't get you to a point where you can say definitively.
What?
Responsibility
for
the crew.
Got our
job secured? Yeah.
The ultimate test for us was going to be, could he provide information that would ultimately lead to a major
box.
Raymond Moody takes up past the Sunset Lodge about 3 miles to a wooded area where
he stood on the mountain. Investigators have a new way for us with the Moody for obstruction of justice so they can pull the people off so they can excavate the site.
And then there's the matter of difficult phone call to Don Drexler.
And I think you've got to be kidding me. And I said, they looked at him in 2012. And I'm like, oh my God, Dawn had called me and she just said, you're never going to believe who it is. And I said, who? And she said, Raymond Moody.
Fortunately, we do have
Brittany was killed at that ball landing. He took her down there, same night she went missing. He raped her.
Oh, thank you, Lord. Then we lose that.
She fought hard.
Any merchant can only think back forward to the time that Moody can be described as scratches on his face as being a result of a wild eagle. If those claw marks on his face were made by her daughter, she fought for her life.
Ground into you.
We lodged Ray overnight in jail. We brought him out the next day, and with his attorneys present, we conducted a far more in-depth and more formal interview. Moody tells investigators that sometime after they got to the coal yard landing, Angel left for a period of time, and that's when Moody, now alone, says he remembers
it. Did you have any inclination at that point when Angel left for what was going to happen next?
Moody says he hid Brittany's body about 150 feet away in a blanket from a broken tree.
He both have been taking it. I'm not going to frustrate. I can carry on. It's stripped out.
He says he retrieved Brittany's body hours later when Angel was sleeping.
If I get it by hand, I'll be blessed, and if I don't, I won't frustrate.
Several days after Brittany's confession, Angel herself came in for what's called a proper interview. In effect, she promises to tell the truth, and in return, they promise to take her cooperation into account in determining whether or not to prosecute her for any involvement she might have had with Spencer that night. Despite having lied, Angel finally admits she was with Ray when they picked up Brittany Drexel on the strip. But she said she was going to be in prison. According to prosecutors, filmmakers showed that there was a time later in the evening at the Pole Yard landing
just make sure
she and Ray were
not together.
Wearing
those nice intelligent hair, fold that into our box, make sure we're grounded here. And we'll stick a side back on the box here.
Yeah,
okay, what's going on? He said, I'm telling you, was she there? And my answer, I got it from the same thing. He never said one word about the night or anything happened. Meanwhile, investigators finally start to dig when Moody said he barely
breathed. All day we dug into the night, but we're all feeling pretty good. Okay,
the box side up here.
Those days of
so this way we'll then maybe down along the side of this emergency switch and shape this. And over the back inside of the wall here. And the thermostat they will just put on the wall up here after they do the shape up. We'll just stick our cover on this.
Listen now to the Daily News Podcast, honored with four Edward R. Murrow Awards.
And see what the New York Times calls it a news podcast
worth listening to. Start here at ABC News and make it your daily first listen. Now that's part of the story that you didn't see. Wherever you get your podcasts, start here.
Right now, there's just so much happening in our world. So much at stake at the start of every morning. Making sense of it all, that's not always so easy. And that's where we come in.
Good Morning America. We want you to know every morning.
We're right here, and we got you.
Here's to Good Mornings America.
Can you hear the love? Oh, yeah.
Mornings that inspire, fill with hope, kindness, joy, surprises, and so much fun.
I can brave it. That's only crazy.
Start your day with Good Morning America. Ray of sunshine, highlighting the best of America and helping
make dreams come true. Wow, I feel so happy. It is so good.
Get ready to smile and put the good into your morning, America. Because
you know what will make the morning better? A little ray of sunshine.
Reporting from Lewiston, Maine, I'm Lindsay Davis. Wherever the story is, we'll take you there. Your strength, ABC News Live.
It's been 13 years since Brittany Drexel suddenly went missing. Authorities now have a confession from registered sex offender Raymond Moody. They will only believe it when they've located Brittany's body.
I talked to them on Monday, and they had started digging up this area where they believe Brittany was put. And in the first few days, they did it.
Beautiful. Here, now it's all nice and covered.